It has been years since most of them attended church.
I was an alcoholic and used cocaine.
But today, these former drug addicts and alcoholics lift their hands in praise to Jesus Christ. They also sing the praises of Youth Challenge, a faith-based group that provides drug and alcohol rehab treatment. Troy Collier is the group's founder.
We're deemed the most successful program around, but particularly by the judicial system and probation and parole offices. We have people, many stories of God's miracles spread all around.
Miracles the ministry hopes will continue.
Youth Challenge has been meeting the needs of hurting people in the community for some 30 years. But the dwindling economy has the ministry facing challenges of its own.
Giving at Youth Challenge was down 30% to 40% last year. That has forced the ministry to find other ways to bring in income, like running a thrift store and an auto repair shop. But what's happening with Youth Challenge is just a snapshot of what's happening around the country. Dan Busby is president of the Evangelical Council for Financial Accountability.
A number of ministries, especially the ones that were more challenged at year end, have taken some steps with regard to personnel. In many cases, hiring freezes have been imposed.
More people are out of work and have less money to spend. Some are exercising caution and giving less.
It caused me to kind of look at my circumstance a little different, say maybe I need to reduce this, maybe I need to reduce that. So yes, I have been somewhat apprehensive.
That has forced ministries to cut spending and some to lay off workers. Donations to the Salvation Army's Red Kettle campaign set a record of $130 million in 2008. But the ministry says giving in some cities is down. Cutbacks at the state and local government level are adding to the problem, according to Independent Sector, a coalition of charities and other nonprofits. The group estimates that at least $15 billion, 18% of all government funding to nonprofit human service providers is being delayed. In turn, faith-based groups are eliminating programs, cutting jobs, or trying to borrow money in an already tight market. Now, a budget plan from the Obama administration could reduce donations even further. The president wants the tax break for charitable donations reduced from 35% to 28% for people making more than $250,000 a year. One study estimates charitable giving would fall by almost 5% under that plan. Some say this is the wrong move at the wrong time. Dan Celia is executive director of the Regency Foundation, a group that provides Christian financial planning.
It's expected giving this year is going to be down 40% on the 42% it was down last year. There are ministries that are going to be in trouble, and this is going to hurt charities across the board. Salvation Army, Red Cross, not to mention the proclamation of the gospel and all those ministries.
But not all of the news is bad. The ECFA found that 72% of its member ministries reported that they met or came within 10% of last year's financial goals.
The impact of the economy is uneven across churches and other Christian organizations. I think some of the organizations that came into the recession in a weak financial position have been impacted the greatest because they simply don't have the flexibility that organizations that came in better prepared.
Meanwhile, pastors see this as a time to encourage their members to trust God, not the economy.
What we must do with the people of God is encourage them that God's economy is not tied to the earth's economy. And God will bless, and we see that throughout the scripture. He did that with the children of Israel. He blessed them even and fed them while other people were in famine. And we've seen this throughout Christian history.
It's a message that prompts some to keep giving.
Me and my husband agreed, though, we're not stopping giving to the Lord because that is what the Bible says. You give, you keep giving, you give of yourself as well, just not the tithe, but ourselves.
I think more and more people realize it's a time to be thankful for what we have. We are very blessed people, even though all of us may have been impacted by the economy. It's a time for prayer for both the churches and parachurch organizations and a time to pray for donors that God will bless them so that they can bless the churches and parachurch organizations as well.
But without those prayers and the support of donors, ministries like Youth Challenge could be forced to close their doors for good. Charlene Israel, CBN News.